Forward to summertime, and in the summertime we would hop in. I just have to say this because it's gnawing at me. So did you buy your tickets at frontrow.com? Because we had no more tickets, but apparently frontrow.com will sell them to you at quadruple the price. I know you did, so I'm sorry. All right. Anyway, at my house, we will look forward to the summertime because summertime was happening. In the summer, and I wouldn't trade it for anything, Mom, because she's here. But in the summer, we would take those long journeys to Long Island. We lived in, you know, mother, daughter, sister, brother house. The brother decided to move to Long Island, which worked out good for everybody. So then we went to Long Island. And we would have barbecues there, especially on the 4th of July or any summer holiday, birthday. It was very exciting. We'd get there, there was grass in the backyard. It was a step up. There was a 4-foot pool in the backyard, too. And that was class. And anyway, we'd have a great time, and just around the time we'd set the marshmallows on fire, they'd have some kind of like Christmas lights or Chinese lanterns or lights in the backyard, which were very festive. And they would play Latin music, and we'd all learn the cha-cha. Which was a good thing, because those album covers, which I fell in love with, and they were albums then, they were about 12 inches. Well, and flat. And, pardon me. In case those of you here didn't think the 4-foot pool was classy enough, I'm sorry. Anyway. So on these covers was always, you know, a guy playing congas, you know, with flouncy sleeves and stuff. And he looked fantastic and very joyous. And there was always some lady in a cocktail outfit, dancing wildly, kind of like this. And I always thought to myself, I want to be her. Anyway, so we'd be dancing in the backyard, learning the cha-cha, and then when you got tired of hanging out with the grown-ups, you'd go in with my cousin, and I'd go into her room, and she'd be playing things like Stay and Johnny Angel, you know, and then Beach Boys. So I just figured all the music was like little kid music, because it all sounded like that. And then when you got tired of that, you'd go out and be listening to the grown-ups' music again. Then I'd go back and listen to my cousin's music again. And then if I stood right in the middle between them both, that's what this next song sounded like. And let me tell you something. We could have a party. We don't need no Chinese lanterns. Because let's face it, the party's in here, baby.
Thank you. thought, maybe I did something really old. So how are you doing?
Thank you. Thank you.
want to sing along with us. How you doing? You okay? All right. So, I love you too, but let me remind you, you don't know who I am. I'm a married woman. But thank you. A beauty, there you go. Where were you 30 years ago? No? You couldn't have been. Unless you were in one of the many, many, many schools I went to. That's what's so frightening when people say, hey, I went to high school with you. I always have to say, which one? I was flunked out of the best places. By the end, they had me in some crazy art class with round scissors cutting paper. It soured me. Anyway, I know. You see, it just goes to show you. A lot of people think, it's bad to be stubborn. It's good to be stubborn. Never listen when people tell you, I don't think you could do that and I don't think you should do that. And there was one thing I was told I shouldn't and couldn't do, but I was doing it anyway. Much to the chagrin of my mom. I'm sorry now. Well, not that much. But anyway, I decided I would do a French version. Wait, I should put this on. Oh, hey, how are you doing? How are you guys? Good? Oh, that's good. Let me just do this because it's French. It's French with an H. Okay, it's got some pirates on it. Hey, what is it? Okay. Oh, get over yourself. What's the matter? Are you having fun yet? Oh, good. Feel free to join in now. Or do whatever it is you want to do, dance or whatever. Remember what happened to Pee Wee. Here we go. The French version. Are you looking French? Okay. One, two.
Images of a newborn magazine. song that I was singing for his survivors, for his friends, and people who loved him. And it was a great healing song, and it went on to mean a lot to the community, mean a lot to people in the world. And I think my pal Lego would be very proud to know that I was singing it for him.
Don't.
balcony thinking, I can't see him, what's up at that? And also I got to do amazing things in my life, like what I always wanted to do, sing. And also, amazingly enough, I'm gonna also drop the ball with them. I keep going over in my head, should I take this opportunity to sing? Hey, Mike! Can you turn my amp up just a tad, George? Dr. Murray, thank you. Oh, get over yourself, is it here? Thank you. That's okay. I can do it. When I first sang the song, I kind of sang it like this, and there was a little dog named Orbit, and we were kind of auditioning for a movie. I mean, we didn't record it yet, so I was singing it, and we didn't have any music, as some singers will, when you write the melody and not the chords yet. I didn't figure that part out. And so I sang it, and every time I got to the chorus, the little dog that was waiting to come in, he waited. And then he barked. He's not here to sing it with me. But I kind of do the best I can. I remember that actress from MASH. She was there. What's her name? Sally something. I don't know. Yeah, somebody. The television show. Whatever. She was sitting there. We could be just as glamorous. Okay, let's see. Here we go. No dogs, no Loretta Swift. Things like this can always take a little time. I always thought we'd be together down the start to fight and can't get over what was said. 'Cause you see black and white and I see red. And I wonder who. And I wonder who. little cue? That was so, so subtle. All right. Where's my stuff? Oh, there it is. You may have noticed I play a lot of the plastic instruments. Hey, guys, you know, I never introduced everybody, and I should, because they're really great. And I gotta say, you could stand on your head, but without great musicians and a great band, where the heck would you be? Standing on your head, there you go. Now, dirty trick. Okay, let me introduce the regular band members first, and then I'll introduce Mitch, Dan, and John, and guys. Okay, here we go. Hey, Remy. This is Remy. We'll start with the newcomer. You know, I've been reading a lot of People magazine, so I keep messing up my name because I got somebody else on the brain whose name is Dim. But this is not Demi, this is Denny. Denny Bonet on violin. Bass guitar, and actually recorded the last CD and mixed it with Russ. Title name is William Whitman. On drums and loops, I had the pleasure of playing with my friend here for two CDs, and I tell you, Sammy, I love him. Drums and loops, Sammy Marandino. My friend! Yeah, right? Man or woman, one of the best guitar players I've ever met. Ted Dyson! And on keyboards, the guy that I started the at last CD with. Breaking me. No. My dear friend and a wonderful, wonderful musician. Nothing short of brilliant on at last. Nothing short of that. Steve Gabor. Now on congas. Without the flouncy sleeves, but great, great player. Roger Sequeiro. Spitero. I can't even remember Roger, I'm sorry. But playing with you in your songs made me totally different. Thank you so much for your rhythm. And my guys over there, we got the other rhythm guy now. That's right. You see this guy over here? Playing fierce good set. Timbales. I get a little stupid at the end of the night, I'm sorry. On timbales, Bobby Allende. And you guys played with us on The View, right? Tell me. And on sax first. Mitchell Fromm on sax, Herman. And on trombone, Dan Reagan. And John Walsh on trumpet. These are great players and we're just lucky enough to have them with us tonight, really and truly. We don't always get treated with you guys. Thank you. Because if you didn't win, I'd be. I knew it, I was an unwed mother. And he was gone. And I said to myself, wait a minute. This is a daydream. What am I doing? So I got over it quick, and then I stopped listening to the monkeys. For obvious reasons. And then in 1985, through a friend, I met Davy Jones. And I was very polite, shook his hand, I said, hi, how you doing? But deep down inside, I was thinking, you bastard. So never meet anybody famous that you really like. Now, I never really told him because I didn't want to scare him, and I thought that was a right thing to do. Anyway, are you tired? What are you talking for? I'm singing all night, sitting. All right. Anyway, and when I was six, no, my mother used to play satchel. Excuse me, Mom. You know, Mom, Catherine, Katrine Dominique. You saw her in the videos. No, she likes her privacy. She's sitting among the people. Anyway, she used to play Satchmo all the time, Louis Armstrong. And we would dance wildly together. Me, my sister, my brother, my mother. Then my mother would go to work. And then we'd play her record again and dance wildly all over the furniture. Mom, that's what happened. The song. I guess not a lot has changed. But let me tell you that. One, I chose this song, this next song, this Satchmo song, to close the CD at last because, one, it's a joyous song, and when I went out into the world, I had a big decision to make. I was either going to be a happy person or a sad sack on parade. So I decided to choose the high road, and when I did, I also remembered that Satchmo was not just celebrated for his great musicianship, because he was a great trumpet player, but also for his wonderful, wonderful smile and the way he spread his joy all over. And he didn't have great beginnings. So I just always wanted to remember to find my joy. And this person found his joy. So on that note, that's